In today's video, we're going to make some basic interactions. First, let's create a link. To do so, go to the Properties tab and use the Create Link shortcut. Select a page from your prototype and voila, you're done. So if you want to edit the link, double-click the interaction. By default, you can open the page in the same tab. You can select to open the page in a different tab or in a new window. And you can also link to an external location. Let's preview this. Now you see, I have a link, but I don't have a rollover. To add this, lower in the Properties tab, you have interaction styles, and you should use these for all the interaction styles, like mouse over. Then let's change the background color, for example, of the link. You see there's a preview, so you can decide which color you think fits best with your design. You can experiment. So let's take some kind of reddish hue. This one? Okay, let's just go with this for now. Go to the Style tab and notice that this did not change the CSS, so you have to make the modification on all the buttons you want it to appear on. The same goes for the shapes. Let's repeat this for the link, mouse over, underline. Okay. Now let's create a menu, for example. Copy paste a bunch of buttons using Ctrl C and Ctrl V or Ctrl D to duplicate them. Just select all the items, align them properly, and then distribute them horizontally. It will generate something quite clean. If you want to have the same interaction styles, you can actually select multiple items. So you just have to do the interaction once. For example, let's add our fill color on rollover. And then we'll also create a style for when a menu is selected. Let's make this the orange with white text style. Now if I click on preview, I have my rollovers everywhere, but now when I click, I don't really see the selected style, so we'll have to add this interaction. You want it to happen on click, so double click on click, then look for the option set selected or checked and select this widget because you want to activate the widget that you're clicking on. You can just decide to activate it or toggle. If you select toggle, whenever you click, the second click will unselect it again. And then you can just copy-paste this interaction on all the buttons. Now if I click on preview, I still have my rollover, but when I click, I can select and deselect any button in whatever order I want. You can also do the same by enabling and disabling buttons. So let's add a style for disabled button. Let's make it gray with gray text, so it looks like you cannot click it. Usually, you'll want a button to be disabled when you click on a different button, so in Axure the interaction will be slightly more complex. Edit one of the buttons by double-clicking the interaction. This time, we're going to use the enable-disable interaction. And now you notice that since we didn't give a name to the button, it will be hard to find it in the list. So give it a name. And then if you use the hide unnamed, you'll automatically see the ones that you're interested in pop up. And select disable, preview. Now you see all the buttons work. but if I select this one, the other button will become disabled. This is very convenient to simulate things like a color, a piece of clothing being available only in a specific size. Then you cannot select one option if the other is selected. You can do the same the other way around. You can set something selected by default, for example, and disable this by default. And now instead of disabling the button, I will enable it. Click on preview. You see this button is now selected by default. This one is disabled. And if I click here, it will enable the other button again. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching.